Hi everyone, welcome back to my next video. Today we are going to take a tour with Gene of our nice van. But before we do, I want to remind you that we just shot an explanation of her limitations and why she's out here. So go watch that. Watch that before you watch this video of the tour. But if you're interested in seeing how someone with physical limitations and handicaps can live in a van, that's what we're going to do today. So let's go do that now. So Gene, now we're inside your van and you've got a recliner. I love recliners in vans.
Yeah.
So tell us all about that.
Well, this is it's actually an electric zero gravity recliner, and it's my seat when it's, you know, I want to sit and look outside and enjoy the view. But at nighttime, I just grab it and slide it out so it's away from the wall or away from the window, and then I can recline in it and sleep in it. So this is my bed and my lounge chair. All at the same time.
Yeah.
So it only uses this much space, which is in a van. And this is not the long wheelbase. This is the one step up from the shortest one. This is the 136. So there's not a lot of room in here. I mean, it's pretty small. But for one person, it's plenty.
Right.
Yeah.
But when you eliminate the bed, that really opens it up.
Yeah, it's a lot of space.
Right.
So yeah.
If there's any way a person can learn to enjoy sleeping in a recliner, that's the way to go.
Yeah, see, and that's what I've been in for a while anyway. I've been in an adjustable bed and for me to be able to function in. And so that's just the step to this is a very easy step into this same situation. And for anybody that's back is really bad, this is actually very comfortable.
So let's take a look around and you can show me how you have arranged everything to work for you.
Well, and I just left it the way it is, so it's its own mess right now. It's its normal mess.
Right.
So I have it where, I call this my nightstand. So this is like the stuff that I would need at night. I have my water and my medications and things all here.
Mm-hmm.
And then I have my, back here is my shower bag. So like if I go someplace to shower, I've got shower shoes and soap and everything in there. And then I have some cookbooks here, some camp cookbooks. So just for fun reading while I'm... And if I meet up with somebody that needs a recipe, I collect cookbooks. That's my collection. Yeah, so this is my electronics wall, I call it. So it's my my solar reader, you know, so I know what the solar is. I've got this covered because it's really obnoxious at night. It's
yes.
A little light. It's bright, bright, bright.
Mine is too.
Yeah, and so then I've got plugs and, you know, barrels and USB. And then that's my lights. So I've got two LED lights on the ceiling.
Mm-hmm.
And then I've got lights throughout the... You won't be able to see them, I don't think, daytime, but let's look. See how they just came on down there?
I did, yeah.
Yeah, and so these will turn on all these low lights at night if I just want a little bit of light.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just, I just stuck a magnet strip on the back, and it just lives up there on that wall.
We learned in the interview, you still own a home in Phoenix.
Yes.
So this is trips for in the van.
Right.
And this is probably more convenient for you here than it is at home. Everything is in one spot.
Yeah, it actually kind of is.
Yeah.
It's actually kind of like everything is like from here. I can kind of reach like everything.
Basically, live your life right here.
I could. I do at night. I live in this chair. I mean,
right.
I get in it, get comfortable, pull it out, sleep in it, get back up in the morning. And you know, it's because it's not a big van. See, this is kind of my living area right here.
But, you know, that's what you do at home. You have a living area. That's where you spend all your time.
You do. Yeah, I've got a recliner home, and that's my living area at home. That's where I'm in. I'm in that recliner reading my book all the time. I knew I wanted to build it out, and I was trying to figure out how to do... I didn't want to do cabinetry because I couldn't build it, and I didn't have anybody that I really could ask to do that. That's a lot of work to build custom cabinetry for a van. We both know that. So these are made for vans because they see at the top the angle for the ceiling, you know, for the curb.
Correct.
So I just ordered these. They actually came in already built. You would think they'd come in parts, but they came in built. And my son installed them. So they're secured to the floor. They're secured to the van wall up at the top. I don't know if you can see that or not. There's a little angle up there.
Mm-hmm.
And then, so this one is the bigger of the two. That one's a little shorter, but they're same height, but width-wise. And the nice thing about these is the shelves are completely adjustable to the height you want.
Right.
So I knew I wanted those bins, that size bin on these shelves,
mm-hmm.
and that shallower bin on those shelves. So we basically arranged the shelves to fit the components that were going to go on them. So like down there on the bottom of that shelf you're pointing at, that big black case is a stove. It's one of the Camp Chef's oven and stove combinations.
Yeah. Love those things.
And then the black box to the left of it's a water heater. So those I can pull out from the back door when I'm in a situation where I want that kind of capability, like I said, if it's just me for an overnight, I use my mini kitchen, which is down where your feet are, basically. But yeah, so my living stuff's all over here. Clothes, cleaning products, you know, all that stuff's kind of over here. Mm-hmm. And then the back wall, and then to your left is all my kitchen stuff. So pantry and kitchen items.
Very good.
Yeah.
And all the shelves on top.
Uh-huh.
Just made good use of all that.
They're all got little bins. And I've been a little lucky to find bins that fit, like, because it's 14 and a half inches deep. So you go to the store and you take your little tape measure and you find bins that fit in that space. So, because everything is so much better in, it's contained better in bins,
you know. You've got little, on the walls, you got little magnetic hangers.
Yeah. These are great. These are from Harbor Freight. I've got them here. They are really, really, really strong. And they hold, they don't come, nothing comes off of those Harbor Freight ones. And I found some cheaper ones, but they just slide right off the wall. But yeah, so that's this is an IKEA thing, mm-hmm. IKEA special, and it holds so much stuff. You know, little stuff. You just have lots of little stuff sometimes in a van that you got to figure out where it's going to live, mm-hmm. you know? And then this unit over here is, it's called Steel Tech. It's from Lowe's, and you buy all those components. So they're all like pipe, you know, like you think of PVC pipe junctions. These are all different configuration. And so what we did was measured this area, knew we wanted to put the fridge over here, knew I needed shelves for pantry. And so Bobby, my friend that's here hanging with us, built that and then built the shelves, and then we secured the shelves on there, and then he put the angle iron on the front so stuff doesn't slide out. And so it's just all open, which people that like real streamlined look, this would bother, but I don't want to try to crawl in and out of a cabinet. I can't. Mm-hmm. My back won't let me. So everything had to be really, really available. And so that's my butane stove, and that's my mini kitchen. So that red basket, and if you want to pull it out, you can. It's got, you know, like, a little, all stuff just for me. Like, I can cook for me completely out of there. There's spatula and, you know, and saucepan and fry pan and little griddle and then a little, like, kind of like a jet boil, but it's the cheap version of a jet boil. Yeah. and
no, that's right here. So
yeah.
That's
the butane can. Yeah.
Here's the jet boil clone.
Yeah. That's the jet boil. Clone. It's in
all
it.
Your kitchen.
And that's my kitchen.
Then you can just slide it around and get it outside the door.
Yeah.
To cook outside.
Yeah. I'll drop that table that's out there outside, and then I just slide that out and stick it on the table.
Then there's the butane stove in the little case.
Yep.
So you pull them out here and cook inside, or pull them out?
Yeah, I've done both. I've cooked inside and outside. Depends on the temperature and the weather and what I feel like.
Just kitchen stuff?
Yeah, that's all kitchen underneath there. Under the fridge is the stove, the 12-volt trucker stove, you know, one of those. And there's a crock pot underneath there, and there's all kinds of stuff under the refrigerator. And then my heavy-duty step stool, if I need it for anything. Like to get up here, I can't get to the back of this up over the head. So I have to have a good step stool. So that's my heavy step stool.
And so this is just a 110 apartment-sized fridge that put in your van.
Yep. It was in my classroom for like 10 years before I retired. And I had it, and I asked my guy that did my solar, I said, can it run it? And he looked at the amperage on it, and he said, yep, it'll run it.
How much solar do you have?
I have 300 on the roof, and I have 420 amp hours in batteries. And they're all down here. You can see them if you move that TV tray, is kind of in the way. But underneath this carpet, down there's the batteries, and then behind here's all the electronic stuff.
Right.
Yeah, you can kind of move that out of the way. That's where the batteries are, is down below. And then that's my utility shelf, the one you're kind of pointing at. That's all my tools and bungee cords and tie-down straps and my extra butane and all that stuff.
It's perfect. Everything's right there and easy to reach and easy for you to get around in.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
It's just really ideal how you set this up.
And I've got this little curtain here that goes across. I've got it wrapped up around, but normally it's down, and I can just pull it across. Mm-hmm. And if I want to go back in and change, because my clothes are right back there in packing cubes, or use the bathroom, and like I'm someplace I don't want to put all the curtains up and do all that, I just pull that across, and I've got a little private area in the back.
Well, I have to ask. Uh-huh. You know, it's just dog.
I know.
How do you go to the bathroom?
Well, my porta potty's right there.
Oh, right. Sure.
Yeah, and that's a sand sport, I think it is. It's one of the ones that I use it with a biogel.
Uh-huh, yes.
Yeah, so I just put a little, like, trash bag in there and put biogel in there, and I'm good to go.
Right.
And then I don't have a shower in here, obviously. I don't have room for a shower. I do have a hot water heater, though. If I wanted to set it up somewhere and, like, wash my hair or wash dishes and stuff, it would work. And I could set it up for a shower if I had some sort of enclosure. And I could still do the back door type of thing that a lot of people have done. I just haven't done it yet. But I have the body wipes. I just use that. And then I every 3-4 days, I go someplace where I can take a shower.
A real shower.
And I've sat in my doorway and washed my hair, you know, and on an asphalt or some surface that's not going to get real muddy. Mm-hmm. So I've done that, you know. So you figure out ways to make it
you
work.
Do. Well, you know, humans have lived for millions of years without showers, indoor plumbing.
Yeah.
And we figured it out.
We figured it out.
Yeah.
We function. We make it work. Yeah.
You know, our ancestors came across the plains in Conestoga wagons, and they figured it out. Mm-hmm. And surely we can too.
Yeah. And this is a swivel seat. I just don't have it swiveled right now. I didn't do this one because it wouldn't make any sense because of this chair to swivel. But this will swivel all the way around.
That's very nice.
And that's nice for somebody to sit and chat, you know, with you and stuff.
Very nice.
Yeah. And that's my... I have my junk drawer up there and my batteries. That's my little cubby. That's the nice thing about these vans is they really have given you a lot of this extra space to store. And then the overhead thing is great. You know, I keep actually I've got the up there, those black things, you can kind of see them a little bit. They actually go in the windows.
Oh.
And when you roll the windows up, it's a screen and a vent and it's steel. So you can, like, it's very secure. You can leave the vehicle that way. And when at night, I can turn my fan on and have those there, and I have a really nice cross breeze.
Mm-hmm. So you had somebody commercially do nearly this whole van. Would you like to give them a plug?
Yeah, it's State Trailer in Phoenix. And Scotty is the guy that I dealt with. He's great to work with. They did the solar. They did the awning. They put in the fan vent, the fantastic fan, the lighting, and then this wall. You know, and the batteries. So they did a lot of this stuff. You know, we just did kind of the infrastructure. I mean, they did the infrastructure. We did the shelving and that stuff. But the real important stuff that makes it function, they did.
Right.
Yeah, and it's State Trailer in Phoenix.
Good. And do you have any social media?
I have a Gmail account. If somebody wanted to contact me, it's white.endeavors@gmail.com. If they wanted to contact me to ask a question about how to do any of this. But I don't have, I need to do either an Instagram or a Facebook. I'm on Instagram and on Facebook, but it's just personal stuff. It's not this.
Yeah.
But I should do one. I probably should do an Instagram of this.
There are people who would like to know how you're doing this.
And maybe do some pictures as I go places. That would be cool.
That would be very cool.
Yeah.
Right.
So if I'm at a campsite or any place, this is how I can get around and go... Let's say to the restroom or wherever it might be. It does pretty well. Yeah, they got to be, if they're not too deep. If they're deep, it gets a little tough. It digs in, but it does okay.
Well, this is called desert concrete. It seems like it does well on desert concrete.
Yeah, it does well. But this is the back. It's just a capability that's the easiest way to get to the campsite and to the water heater back here. And
can you lift the campsite in and out?
I have usually if I do the campsite, I've got somebody with me.
They're fairly heavy.
Yeah. Yeah, it's probably 40 pounds would be my guess.
I would, you know, I would give pause before I would just start throwing it around.
Yeah, I only use that. That's only when I've got other people.
Right.
I've got able people with me that can help. But it's back here and it's available. There's my basically breaker box for my power right there in that box there. And then because I told them my kitchen might be at times back here, they put me in an outlet so I could have electrical stuff back here if I wanted. And then my clams in that corner right there to your right. And you see it back in there? And my little rug. And then sometimes I put in if I'm going someplace where I want an umbrella, I put a market umbrella in there. But that little corner wasn't planned, but it ended up being just the perfect size for stuff, for tall, skinny things.
Camping, outdoor stuff.
Yeah. So I don't have like the garage like everybody else has, but you know, this is the way it worked the best. And then a happy accident, the table, that you see that banquet table, uh-huh. The way my son configured the shelves, didn't do it on purpose, made that space perfect to slide that table in there. And it wasn't, we didn't measure, we didn't try, it was one of those, oh look! So this is my backside. Don't open it often because the lift's kind of a pain to swing away. And I mean, it's right. Doable, but... Right. But so, I wanted to make sure I can get everything from the inside if I had to.
There's a lift for the...
The scooter.
Mm-hmm.
So it all... My trips are different. I configure the van for whatever kind of trip I'm doing. Is it just me traveling cross country, one night stands, different places, so it just has to be the little mini kitchen and all that? Or is it a group of people going someplace for a week? Well, then I configure the, you know, the Dutch oven table goes in, the Dutch ovens go in the van, this comes out, you know, everything is back here is more big group camping.
Well, Gene, thank you so much for sharing your home with us. Just so admire your spirit that you're not going to let your physical limitations hold you back. You're going to go live.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
And see cool stuff all over the United States.
Yeah. And it's a real inspiration. Thank you.
Thanks.
So, folks, there you have it. I know you've been inspired by Gene's story and her adventurous spirit. And if so, like us on YouTube, subscribe to the channel, hit that thumbs up button, and we'll talk to you later.